Three kids, thanks for joining us for Junior Church today. You know, we're all staying home a lot now, and I hope during this extra time at home, you're getting to make some special memories with your family. Maybe trying something new, digging a board game out of the closet that you forgot about years ago, maybe baking some new recipes. I've been baking. Here's a loaf of bread I made a couple of days ago, and my family dug into it for breakfast. It's really yummy. During today's Bible account, you're going to hear how Satan tempted Jesus, and bread comes into the story. Listen out for it. Now, I'm going to challenge you to listen for three ways that Satan tempted Jesus during our time today. First was about God's provision. Would God provide what Jesus needed? Satan also tempted Jesus about God's power to protect him. The last thing that Satan tempted Jesus about was God's plan for the kingdom. See if you can find those three during our story time today. Now I know we all face temptations every single day, but this story teaches us how Jesus gave an example of us being able to use God's word, the scriptures, to be able to fight against temptation and stand for what is true. But even better than that, boys and girls, Jesus used this time to tell us that he is not just a mere man. He has power over Satan and over sin. And because of what Jesus did on the cross, conquering the power of Satan and sin, you and I can have forgiveness for our sins too. That's good news.
After Jesus was baptized, God's Spirit led him into the wilderness. Jesus stayed in the wilderness for many days. He prayed to God and thought about God's plan for his life. Jesus did not eat anything while he was in the wilderness, and he was very hungry. The devil came to tempt Jesus. He tried to get Jesus to do wrong things. The devil said, "If you are really God's son, tell these stones to become bread." If Jesus used his power to turn the stones into bread, he could eat the bread. Then he wouldn't be hungry anymore. But Jesus said no. He trusted God to give him what he needed. Then Jesus said, "This is what the Bible says. Man must not live only on bread, but on all the words God says." Jesus did not sin, so the devil tried again. He took Jesus to the top of the temple in Jerusalem. The devil said, "If you are really God's son, prove it. Jump off the top of the temple. God will protect you." Then the devil said, "The Bible says God will order his angels to keep you safe, and they will protect you so that you will not even trip on a stone." Again, Jesus said no. Jesus knew the devil was trying to trick him by misusing God's words. The devil was being foolish. Jesus said, "The Bible also says, do not test God." Finally, the devil took Jesus to a high mountain where they could see land stretched out far and wide. The kingdoms and land were great. The devil said, "Look, I will give you all the money and power of these great kingdoms. All you have to do is fall down and worship me." Jesus said, "No, go away," he said. "The Bible says, only worship God and only serve God." So the devil went away. Angels came to help Jesus and serve him. In all of these things, Jesus never sinned. The devil tried to get Jesus to sin, but Jesus never sinned. Jesus always did the right thing. Jesus died on the cross to rescue us from sin. When we are tempted to sin, we can ask Jesus to help us say no to sin.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Ashley from Burlington, Wisconsin asks,
"How do I know if I'm being tempted?"
You know, Ashley, before I answer your question, let me just talk about what temptation is, just so we can make sure we all are on the same page with that. In today's Bible story, we see that Jesus was tempted, but we know that Jesus never sinned. So that proves to us that there's nothing wrong with being tempted. It's not a sin to be tempted. Let's be clear about that. The sin occurs when we give in to temptation. Notice that's what Jesus did not do. Satan tempted him, but Jesus did not go into that temptation and follow through. He said no, and he didn't act on that temptation. So for us, what we want to do is recognize when we're tempted, like you're asking about today, and then figure out how we can resist temptation. So how do we know we're being tempted? Well, there are a couple things. One, we recognize that something within us is desiring us to go away from God's word instead of going toward him and obey his word. There's something within us, either because of an external, the world around us, or just the selfishness of our hearts, our own desires, that we want to either do what we know the word of God says we do not do, or we don't want to do what the word of God says we should do. Either of those are temptations to disobey God, to not obey him fully. And so we just want to be careful that we recognize when we're having these thoughts, when our hearts are moving in us in those directions, and we recognize those are not of God, those are of the world, those are of sin. And so we want to fight against that. So how can you fight against temptation? Well, there are a couple things you can do. The first thing you can do is remember the word of God. Again, this is how we test everything. And so if you desire to do something that's not in the word of God that goes against it, you know it's wrong. And so you can fight against that. You can share with other believers. Have somebody hold you accountable. Go to them and say, hey, something within me, I just want to disobey God. I want something that's not in line with his word. Will you pray with me? And that's the third thing you do. You can pray to God. Ask God to help you. Ask God to reveal that what you desire is not the best for you. Ask him to help change your heart so that you want only what he wants, only what is best for you truly, because it's what is his will. So I got a question back for you. What are some strategies you use to fight temptation?
In the beginning was the Word.
In the beginning was the Word.
And the Word was with God.
The Word was with God.
And the Word was God.
The Word was God.
He was with God in the beginning.
John 1:1-2.
In the beginning was the Word, was the Word.
In the beginning was the Word, was the Word.
And the Word was with God.
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 And the Word
You were born into this world, living in our limitations and our hurt. The promise of a healing Savior, fully God and fully man, the sacrifice for all, the spotless Lamb. The great I Am, redeemed us with His outstretched hands. Jesus Messiah, firstborn of heaven, perfect salvation to redeem all men. Jesus Messiah, love's definition, willingly broken for all our sin. Jesus Messiah.
Face. You were perfect in your nature.